Welcome to class, students. In this class, we discuss both if and not if gates. Gates with an additional control signal on buffer and not gates are also available. So that control signal value, if it is 1, it is referred as buffer if control signal is 1, buff if 1, not gate if control signal is 1, not if 1. Buff if 0, if control signal is 0 for buffer, not if 0, control signal is, suppose it is 0. These gates propagate only if their control signal is asserted. They propagate Z if their control signal is not applied, D asserted. You can compare this buffer. You can identify a triangular shape. It represents a buffer symbol, one input and output, then one more additional input which acts as a control signal. This indicates active high control signal. It expects control is 1. When control is 1, output is assigned with input. Second, if you observe for NOT gate, if control signal is 1, then output is assigned with input. Then control signal is 0. Okay, it is referred as buff if 0. A buffer whose control signal is 0, then output is assigned with input. When for NOT gate, if control signal is 0, then output is assigned with input. We can observe the truth tables for buff if 1, NOT if 1, buff if 0 and NOT if 0 gates. If you compare, when control signal buff if 1, we expect control signal supposed to be 1. When control input is 1 and the actual input here value can be 0, 1, x, z, 4 different values possible. So in that case, output that we get when input is 0, we get 0, 1, 1. When unknown, output is also unknown. When input one end is connected in circuit, other end is floating, then output is unknown. So it is resolved as unknown for buff if 1. Similarly, for buff if 0, if you observe, control signal we expect active low signal, control we expect 0. When control signal is 0, output we are assigning with input. When control signal is 0, you can observe here. So input, when it is 0, you are getting 0. When it is 1, you are getting 1. When it is x, you are getting x, unknown. When it is high impedance z, you are getting unknown. Similarly, we can analyze for not if 1 gate also. Not if 1 refers to control signal refers we expect 1. In that case, it behaves like a not gate. So 0, 1, 1 means 0, complement form. X, unknown, unknown. Z is resolved as unknown. For remaining values of control, if it is 0, if it is unknown or it is not connected, in that case it is resolved as for 0 it is resolved as high impedance, for X and Z it is resolved as unknown. For 0, 1 values H and L, strength levels are different. Similarly, not if 0, if you observe, when control signal is 0, it behaves like a not gate. 0, complement, 1, complement, unknown, Z also you are getting unknown. These gates are used when a signal is to be driven only when the control signal is asserted. Such a situation is applicable when multiple drivers drive the signal. These drivers are designed to drive the signal on mutually exclusive control signals. Instantiation of buff if gates. How to use or create an instance of buff if gates? Okay, you can observe buff if 1, buff if 2, buff if 0. So these are predefined components. B1 and B0 are component instances. It has got one output, out, and input and control. IN, in, and control. These two are defined for buff if 0 and buff if 1. This is how we need to instantiate gates. Buff if 1 and buff if 0 gates. Similarly, you can instantiate not if 1 and not if 0 gates also. not if 1 and not if 0, n1 and n0, okay, we can define. Here also one output and two inputs, input and control signal. Array of instances. There are many situations when repetitive instances are required. These instances differ from each other only by the index of the vector to which they are connected. To simplify specification of such instances, Verilog HDL allows an array of primitive instances to be defined. Consider an example, wire 7:0 out IN1, IN2. So here out is also 8 bit width, IN1 and IN2 are also 8 bit width, we have defined as wire. Then we are doing basic gate instantiation, NAND N_gate, then here you are mentioning size 7:0 out comma IN1 comma IN2. This is as good as we are defining an array of 8 different and NAND gates defined. This is equivalent to writing 8 instantiation statements, NAND N gate 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like this. For first gate instance, you will have out of 0, IN1 of 0, IN2 of 0 as inputs. So we have defined 8 different NAND gates, 2 input NAND gates, by using an array of instances concept, where input and outputs are defined as a vector, a 8 bit width, and then we are creating an instance. Instead of writing these 8 different statements within code, we can write only one statement. This particular system statement is capable of generating 8 different NAND gates, which are need to be defined with these 8 different statements. These can be avoided. Writing 8 statements can be avoided by writing only one instantiation statement. This is an example for an array of instances. Okay, here 7:0 means 8 different NAND gates are created. We'll consider one example, 4:1 multiplexer. So I0, I1, I2, I3, S1, S0 are select lines. These 4 are inputs, these 2 are select lines. So total altogether 6 inputs and 1 output. If you observe truth table of 4:1 mux, it depends on select line value. If it is 0, 0, output is assigned with I0. If it is 0, 1, output is assigned with I1. If it is select line 1, 0, then output is assigned with, out is assigned with I2. 1, 1, then out is assigned with I3, like that, truth table. In today's class, we see how we can implement using a gate level implementation. A gate level implementation means using, say, structural description, how we can write the coding for 4:1 mux. And also we see how to develop a test bench for 4:1 mux. I0, I1, I2, I3, so 4 inputs, select lines, S1, S0. Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3 are the intermediate outputs, S1, N, S0, N, so these are intermediate outputs. So Y0 to Y3, S1, N and S0, N, 6 intermediate outputs, 6 actual inputs, I0 to I3, S1, S0, and 1 output. So these need to be defined in our coding part. We'll see how the coding is developed. So Y0, first AND gate, 3 input AND gate, I0 is connected, then input S1 should be 0, S0 should be 0. So that means we are connecting S1 N, S0 N. So complement, when it is 0, here you will get 1. When S1 and S0 both are 0, through NOT gate, this output will become 1, 1. Now entirely output depends on Y0 value. If it is 0, you will get Y0 0. If it is 1, you will get Y0 1. This is further connected to OR gate. Okay, and you can observe the final output. If it is 1, then remaining gate output is not checked. So for OR gate, when one of the input is 1, so output suddenly becomes 1. If it is 0 and previous outputs are all 0, then you will get output as 0. So this is a logic schematic for 4:1 multiplexer that we are going to implement. This is a truth table, this is a symbol representation. The symbol is used to declare the module part. So you can observe module mux 4:1 out. You can observe module mux 4:1 out I0 to I3 S1 S0. So 6 inputs you have defined, you have separated I0 to I3, output out, and then intermediate inputs you have defined S1 and S0, wire S1N, S0N. So these intermediate outputs are defined as wire Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3. So once declaration is over with respect to symbol and schematic, symbol gives you input and output, schematic will give you the all gate level implementation on a paper, and there you can identify which intermediate output signals we need to define. Those intermediate signals are defined as wires in Verilog. Now you can observe how to generate S1N, S0N. So here we can use of NOT gate. So there can be instance name or without instance name also we can do the declaration part. So here instance names are not used, so NOT is created with here you can see a 4 AND gates whose outputs are Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, inputs I0, I1, I2, I3, and first gate S1N, S0N, so 00, 01, 10 and 11, like this select lines are connected. So here you have generated S1N and S0N, inputs are S1 and S0, so 4 different direct and complemented form, both you are connecting. So it requires 4 AND gates, 2 NOT gates to generate S1N, S0N, S0 complement and S1 complement to generate that NOT gate. Here one more observation you have to make is they are not used any instance names, that is also allowed. And here one more important observation, I0, I1, I2, I3, S1, S0 all are 1 bit in size. So I can write here after I3, S1 and S0, and wire here S1N, S0N, Y0 to Y3 on a single line we can write, that is also allowed. Then final these 4 outputs Y0 to Y3 need to be combined to generate an output, OR gate is used. So finally, so this entire thing observation if you make, so the schematic written for that we have made use of predefined gates, NOT gate, AND gate, 2 input AND gates, 3 input AND gates and 4 input OR gate. So this is a gate level implementation for 4:1 MUX. This is not only the only this method where we can implement MUX. We can implement MUX using assignment statement, data flow. You can implement the MUX using case or if statement, a behavioral coding. You can implement a 4:1 MUX using schematic basic gates, the schematic given as an example. So this is known as a gate level implementation. So all entire implementation we have done with the help of basic gates, predefined basic gates. So we can call it as a gate level implementation or structural description. Stimulus for this code, so here also I need to define I0 to I3, S1, S0 and output wire, output should be defined as wire, inputs need to be defined as registers in test bench or stimulus or top level code. Then in this stimulus the 4:1 MUX code developed earlier should act as a component. So here mux 4 to 1 my mux should act as a component. So here the signals from stimulus output IN0, IN1, IN2, IN3, S1, S0 are assigned. These are mapped with the previous declaration. These are mapped with the signals that you have defined in your module mux 4 to 1. So this output is assigned without caps lock. I0, I1, I2, I3 are assigned to these. S1, S0 are assigned to these signals. And results are according to this code only. So top level code, why we are writing? We are writing so that we can assign values through initial statement. Initially, we are assigning IN01, IN10, IN21, IN30. So you want to display these values. #1 dollar display IN0, IN1, IN2 and IN3. So initial values displayed will be 1010. Then display acts as similar to your printf statement. When you make through initial statement S10 and S00 for first combination, of select lines, when S1 is 0, S0 is 0, in that case output should be same as IN0, that is 1. Output should be 1. Similarly, for 01, 10 and 11 combination, you are displaying values of S1, S0 and output. And this will be available as tabular form. We have seen in simulation in earlier videos. Okay. The final output of this stimulus block, where mux 4 to 1, my mux, this code, mux 4 to 1 is your code, my mux is the instance name. Okay. This will act as an component, and values you are supplying through this initial statement, as well as you are displaying those values. The final simulation output will be somewhat like this. First it will display 1010, IO10 to IN3 values. Then each combination 00, it will display 1, IN0 value is 1. For 01, it is 0. For 10, it is 1. For 11, it is 0. Like that. And thank you, students. We will continue in next class.